can never ever find the right words, and there's no way this is real life. There's no telling you.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. In today's video, we're gonna be working on the M4 again. Yes, technically it was completed in the last video, but in today's video, the M4 does need a lot of things. It still needs the seatbelt tensioner rebuilt, the seatbelts rebuilt. It needs a new control arm. Once those three things are done and the headlight coated, then the car is absolutely ready to go off to the paint shop. Once you get back to the paint shop, the car is good to go. But as of right now, let's try to knock out two birds with one stone. Instead of taking the car down to LNG Solutions and letting them have the car for 2 to 3 days and take off the seatbelt, the tensioner, all that stuff, let's leave the car here with us, take the seatbelt tensioner and take the seatbelt to LNV Solutions over there. They're about a 45-minute drive. Buy a control arm from BMA European, which is right next to them. Come back over here, install that, and we can actually get some things done locally, like smog, headlight and brake, everything super, super, super local that we can take some back roads on, because obviously we want to be safe. And I want to get that headlight coated because we won't pass braking light without that headlight coated. So let me go hit up Nick real quick and see if he can help me code in that headlight. At the same time, shout out to Nick. He actually sent me out one of these Ozone, whatever you call them, systems. So this is what you put inside. Is it called an Ozone? What is this thing called? This thing, basically, you put it in the 7 Series and it takes out all that smoker smell out of the car and basically lets it smell like a non-smoker car, which is absolutely perfect. So that's awesome. The 7 Series smells so bad, I really don't even want to drive it because of how bad it smells. It's like heavily a smoker car. Cannot wait to get that all out, put some air fresheners, and just make the car smell a lot better. We also have a lot of pieces for the 7 Series chilling right there. That whole rack is for the 7 Series. And the interior is gonna be completely transformed, the exterior, the maintenance. We're gonna try to pretty much do as much as we can to it, but that's not today's video. Again, we're kind of pushing off a little bit more. We're also doing the merch drop with the 7 Series. Hopefully when the 7 Series drops, you guys know new merch is dropping as well. Very limited quantity, think 90 of each thing. So stay on the lookout for that. Anyway, let's get the i8 out of here, get the M4 in here, and start taking the car apart. First things first, guys, is go ahead and just disconnect the battery because we need to take out the driver's seat and the actual seatbelt right here. So you guys can see this seatbelt is completely just seized up. There's no good to it. And as for this, this is blown. So we need to take that out. We need to take this out. Let's go ahead and disconnect the battery and start working on those two things first. Now that the battery disconnected, let's go ahead and remove that seat real quick. I'm so stupid sometimes. I haven't removed this seat in a long time. Let's go ahead and reconnect the battery, move the seat back, take out those two bolts, move the seat forward, take out those two bolts, and then disconnect the battery. Yeah, yeah, because obviously now we can't even move the seat and we need to move it. So as you guys can see, our problem is right here. So this can actually get rebuilt. I didn't know that. I usually just buy a whole new tensioner. This can actually get rebuilt at LND Solutions. These things run about $150 for the M4s. He can actually repair this for probably like less than half the price or even half the price, which is way better than buying a new one if there's nothing wrong with this one. So if we can get that repaired, we'll be good to go on this. But right now, let's go ahead and try to get this seatbelt out. I think what we need to do is actually remove this door panel. And to remove this door panel, we need to remove these rear seats and remove that section right there on the side. Remove the door panel, and then we can actually remove this piece right here. So we just pulled out these three pieces, which is the only pieces we pretty much need to pull out for the seatbelt, I think. Yeah, so now the seatbelt is fully exposed, as you guys can see. Oh, that's actually kind of interesting. There's another airbag sensor right here. So just in case you guys ever get quarter panel damage, there you guys have it. If you guys have an airbag light and you don't know what it is, it's right there. That's crazy. I didn't know that. Anyhoozles, so we need to take out this bolt down here, and that will release this guy, and also this clip right here that actually releases the airbag module, the actual thing itself there. And then this, I believe we just pull on it, pop out the tabs, and then we can pull this out. I think that's how that works. So let's just go ahead and try to get this thing out. I've removed it on a four, on the 435. You guys know that we changed the color on these, so I don't think it's any different. So let's go ahead and just try to get these out. Hopefully they're pretty easy. Now that we got the seatbelt out, we can finally take this down to L&D Solutions and put back all the bolts from every single place that I took it out of, just to make sure it's where it needs to be. And this bolt, I just put it right back into here, just so I don't lose it. But yeah, hopefully this thing can get rebuilt by L&D Solutions. Super, super, super happy about that. Let's go ahead and try to remove this guy now, so we can actually put back the seat. So at least you can move the car around, but at the same time, we have everything we need to take down to L&D Solutions for them to repair. Alright guys, so you guys just saw it. We pretty much removed the seatbelt tensioner, which is sitting right there. The seatbelt, which we're good to go. I put all the door panels and everything into the car. Even the rear seats, I threw it in there, but everything on this side is missing. Even the seatbelt feels so weird. There's no seat buckle, no seatbelt. But at least now we can move the car around. We can take those things to go get worked on and maybe even drive it down to smog. I don't know, we'll see. I'm not really too comfortable driving this car without a seatbelt. It's just, you know, I'm not worried about my driving. I'm worried about the next person's driving, and you never know what can happen in life. So trying to play a little bit safe. We do have the car in a trickle charger though, and I'm on the phone with my boy Nick, and we're gonna try to see if the headlight on this side is a coding issue, because as soon as I unplug it and replug it, it works just fine. And every time I unlock the car, it flashes like as if it wants to work, but it won't work. So we came down to the conclusion that it might be a coding issue, and it just might need to be just programmed to this car. So I have Nick on the computer with me. We're gonna go ahead and give it a shot here, and yeah, hope for the best. If this thing works, we should have no errors other than, you know, the seatbelt stuff. And this car is almost on the road, guys. I'm super, super, super excited for it. Nick is also gonna figure out my issue with the i8 and the 7 Series. I haven't been able to get some coding done with him in a little bit. He's been very, very, very busy. And in the 7 Series, he's gonna run the codes and just check if the transmission is actually bad. Because when I ran the codes on Carly, it told me the line, whatever, is bad. I looked that up on Google, and it's saying it's a sensor in the Megatronics. And that's it. You have to pretty much replace the entire Megatronics, and then the Megatronics cost more than transmission, and the transmission is leaking. So I just figured ultimately replace the whole transmission. So that's what I came down to the conclusion of. But that might not be a sensor. The car might be just in lock mode. It might be in neutral mode for towing. We don't really know what it is exactly. So we're gonna go ahead and run the codes, figure that out as well. So we got a lot of code things to run. But I mean, hey, there's no better day. Might as well do it. Alright guys, I don't know if you guys can see it. Nick is coding in the headlights right now, and bang, you guys can see now all of it's working. So this side, all of it's working, and this one, as you guys can saw, he had to code in literally every single module, and now the whole headlight's working, and it's actually both leveled. Look at me and my installing capabilities. But anywho, shout out to Nick, finally. Yeah, so yes, everything nowadays does need to be coded. So just an FYI, if you guys plug in something new and it's not working, possibly even the sunroof motor that we installed in the 7 Series, we'll look at that as well, because it's a possibility that after we installed that, it just needs to be coded. The 7 Series, we might as well dig into it a little bit today. Why not? But oh my God, I'm so happy that's actually working now. I thought it had to do with the wiring because that's the side of the accident, but happy man. Guys, so now that we got the 7 Series inside, I actually did try playing with the sunroof a little bit, and it did actually pull back the headliner piece all the way back, so it did work partially. The car keeps beeping because it won't go in park, and oh my God, this thing really smells like a smoker car. Shout out to Nick for also letting me borrow his, is it called like an ozone thing? What is it called? Ozone generator. We're gonna have to definitely put that in the car to suck up all that smoker. It smells so bad, guys. Whoever that was in this car is a heavy smoker. But yeah, hopefully we can try to at least figure out some of these issues and hopefully start fixing them, hopefully in the next video. We do have a new airbag because this thing is bad. We did get the code for that. But hopefully we can figure out the sunroof situation and maybe even the iDrive control because it's not really working properly. And just a few other things, and especially the transmission. Hey, guys, he's doing the initialization. Wow, there's so much debris in here and leaves. Oh my God, this thing needs a full clean out once we get this thing back. Oh my God, finally, guys, sunroof looks like it is working. It is very slow though, but it is working. So guys, something that me and Nick just found out, this car hasn't been updated or pretty much touched by, I don't know if it has been touched by the dealer, but it doesn't look like it's been updated since 2010. So whoever that bought the 7 Series literally never brought it back to BMW, which is the weirdest thing because I mean, 7 Series, guys, don't have a lot of issues. And typically people that are able to afford this brand new would take it to the dealer, but it looks like this one's never hit the dealer, which is very strange. So it looks like, yeah, we do need to do every single bit of maintenance this car needs. And it looks like a lot of things need updating, possibly even the transmission. We will find out, guys. So after scanning the car and everything, we did find out that it is a transmission issue for the transmission thing. The park basically has a sensor inside the Megatronics, and you can just replace that stick sensor. It's kind of like a little motherboard chip. You can just replace that, but it's very hard to get to. So you just end up replacing the whole Megatronics. But again, like I told you, with everything and all that stuff, it pretty much ends up being almost the same price as a used transmission if you can get it for a good deal. And our car has a leak between the engine and transmission, so I kind of want to pull the whole transmission out, replace that seal, put the transmission back, and we're good to go with no leaks. The oil pan is obviously leaking as well, so we want to get that sorted as well. This car, after doing the math, it we're probably going to be in it way more than what it's worth. The headlights, the fender, the bumper, the windshield, the transmission, there's a bunch of things with this car that needs to be replaced. So let me know, guys, is this something you guys want to see on this channel? It is going to be, I'm going to be spending way more money than the car is actually worth, so if we end up selling it, it's probably not worth it. I am really enjoying this car for some reason. I absolutely love this car. I feel like it's better than an SUV. It has more trunk space. I mean, not probably more trunk space, but it has a, like probably the most trunk space I've ever seen in a sedan. Very comfortable rear seats, probably more comfortable than the X5, to be honest with you guys. I really, really, really like this car. Let me know if you guys do want to see this car stay on the channel and fully restored with zero leaks. This is an N54 rear wheel drive, so we can't end up doing burnouts and drift within crazy stuff like that on a 7 Series. So let me know down below. As for the sunroof and the iDrive controller, it started working as soon as you put it on the trickle charger. So the roof shut, it works perfectly fine. The iDrive controller started working. It's really weird. So it looks like it also might have a bad battery that's contributing to a lot of the issues, like the seats not calibrating and a few other things. It could be because of the battery. So again, shout out to Nick. He's helping me figure out a little, you know, little by little, what's going on with our cars. M4 perfectly good, thankfully. This car does need a lot of work, but we're probably gonna end up getting a new battery and then, you know, probably knocking things out after that, because the battery could be confusing a bunch of things and probably not allowing all the modules to stay awake and operate the way it should. All right, guys, so I have some of your guys' packages right there, and I also have the seatbelt tensioner and the seatbelt in the back, so let's head down to Chipotle. Yes, that is the first stop. We gotta get some Chipotle. In the last couple of videos, you guys haven't been really seeing me head out of the house with you guys. I've been pretty much just doing everything from the house, and I think it's important to take you guys on the journey as well. So let's head out, go get some Chipotle, because your man's starving. It's already 3, and I haven't even eaten yet. I'm over here checking my wrist as if I had a watch. It's been some time now. I don't know where my watch went. Anywho, so let's go get some Chipotle. Head over to LED Solutions, head over and hopefully get a control arm for the M4, and just make some progress on this build. This M4 is almost together. Once we get these seatbelts done, no codes on the car, just everything else is gonna be aesthetics. And then hopefully, I mean, we do need to replace the brake pads as well to pass braking light. I think the rear brake pads are kind of bad. Anywho, we'll figure that stuff out. Let's just head over, get some Chipotle. All right, guys, just got here to BMA European. Let's see if they have that control arm. All right, guys, mission accomplished. We just got the new control arm. So let's head home. Actually, no, we gotta head to LND Solutions. They're right around the corner. But hey, guys, we got that control arm though. Now we are heading to LND Solutions. Hopefully we're gonna make it there in time. I'm hoping they're still open, but yeah, we are super, super, super close. Let's just hope we make it. And from those of you guys that know, LND Solutions is right next to our old shop. Let's see if John, yep, John is at the shop right now. Let's go ahead and just, I might actually swing by and just say what's up. But anywho, we are pulling up. Out of respect for them, I'm gonna go ahead and just drop it off. But let's see if they want me to film or not. I'll let you guys know in 3, 2, 1. Alright guys, so I just spoke to Dennis and his brother. Huge shout out to them. Again, I love these guys. Very nice people here at L&D Solutions. So they already gave me a quote for both the things. They're going to get them fixed. They're going to get them worked on. And then as soon as they get both of those stuff things done, they're going to give us a call and hopefully we'll just come pick it up. As for also the car, they do look in the interior and this is a fully spec'd out i8. Even the steering wheel is a custom steering wheel. The only thing we can do to it is the roof. Let me know if we should do starlight roof. I think that'd be super dope. Not the cheapest thing in the world, but it would look really awesome. Not gonna lie. Anywho, so let's go ahead and head out, get working on the M4 because I really want to get that control arm on. We just made it home with the M4, so oh my god, both headlights are working. Shout out to Nick. Apparently, you just needed to be coated. I mean, I kind of knew it, but I didn't really know it just because that side was the side of the accident. So I was kind of feeling like maybe one of the wires are messed up or some of the modules because that is also a different headlight. But it turns out it just needed to be coded after all this. So it's actually fairly easy. You just need to know how to code. But your man, I really need to sit down with Nick one day and hoping he just teach me some stuff so I can teach it to you guys. And let me know if you guys want me to show you guys how to code because I feel like that would make everyone's lives a whole lot easier. Like, let's be real. Anywho, so we just headed down and we just got this control arm. So this is how it's supposed to look. Let's go ahead and pull out the one from the car and show you guys how it's sitting on the car. If you guys see on the bottom, it's all scraped up. And actually on this side, the good side, it's actually very scraped up as well. And I asked him, like, how come is the car low or something? How does it always scrape here? And he's like, well, most of the cars that end up coming from Copart, the forklift goes from the front, picks it up, and ends up scraping all this stuff anyway. So that sucks, but thankfully no actual damage, just scrape marks, nothing too serious. Let's go ahead and jack up the car and remove this guy. Hopefully it should be an easy thing, but it might have some strip bolts, so it'll make it a whole lot harder. But also, your man got the tool. This is the tool that literally makes your life a whole lot easier. Alright guys, so we pull up the one that was in the car, and this is obviously the new to us but used control arm. This is in perfectly good shape. Bushings and everything seems to be in really good condition. Again, from another low mileage M4. These things run about $200 new. I got this for about 80 used, so I'm very happy with this. Same day as well, we got to go pick it up. But this thing is toast. So luckily the other one looks straight. It's just this one that's bent. So let's go ahead, get this thing out of here and just replace it with the new one. So control arm replaced. So that now that that's over with, we can pretty much toss the old one. No need for that. I just made an entire mess. Oops. But yes, finally both headlights work. That control arm is done. This car, as it sits right now, just needs some cosmetic things. Once the whole front bumper gets pretty much fixed up, we do need a grill there, a grill on the other side, and an emblem. But other than that, I think everything else is complete. Oh yeah, and this mirror cap, I don't know if you guys remember, is slightly cracked right here. So we're just gonna have to get a new mirror cap. We'll just get carbon fiber ones, not a big deal. But yeah guys, other than that, we're just waiting on the seat belts, and this thing is 100% street legal and should be driving a-okay. So yeah guys, this car is pretty much ready to go in the next video. Hopefully in the next video we're picking up the seat belts, installing them, taking off the headlight and brake. I don't really know, is the rear brake pads as bad as I think? Because obviously it'll fail brake check. It still has some depth to it. Definitely needs to be replaced, but I do think this will still pass. I don't know if you guys can see it, but yeah, it's not much there. I do think it'll still pass with that though. I'm gonna go ahead and figure out the measurements for the California thing and see if it'll pass with that a little bit. But anywho, that concludes today's video. I think this is part 12, so hopefully in part 13, we should be able to get this thing driving around, getting a whole bunch of things done on the car. Pretty much, again, brake and light and smog. Once we get both of those two things done, pretty much this car is ready for just paint. And then, that's pretty much it. And then I think we can actually start on the mods. I've been really, really, really excited to get this car started on the mods. It does need an alignment as well, so we'll probably have to get that alignment done as well. But anyway, that's enough for one day. My hands are dirty. I'm gonna go upstairs, wash up, get to go to the other house to start working on the other house, because again, we're furnishing, we're moving in, we're getting things situated. Again, hopefully I'll be showing you guys that pretty soon. It's just my fiance's family is living there right now and I don't really want to intrude and I don't want them to feel uncomfortable. So you guys smash that like button goal. So hopefully as soon as I'm able to actually show you guys, I will be showing you guys the place because you guys want to see it. Without further ado, guys, I love y'all so much. Remember to stay humble. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out. Don't forget, new merch dropping soon. Look out for the 740 LI video.